I think it'll help if she needs to.
Little rat that she has.
Yes.
She has, she has.
She's a food you guys.
My dear, she looks fat.
I think she has a palate in there.
She's got so big.
Yeah.
I don't know, we were around back in March.
Mother's Day, you have her palate.
Michael, maybe?
They are so unapologetic about wanting their naps, they're like, I'm not getting up.
Well, you wouldn't wanna wake up right there.
Yeah.
I mean, you would call.
That's about right.
And he wouldn't even open his eyes.
Yeah.
Does she look like a hairless?
What about you?
She's like, I'm gonna watch you. All right, maybe I'll come say hi. Okay, fine. There's enough of you, it's worth it.
And then go back.
What are you doing, Frida? Are you saying hi to everybody?
Oh, the sketches.
Yeah. What?
You're a good girl, I know.
Yeah.
Here comes the treats.
Oh, it's, yeah, she's a guy.
I remember this.
So her hair. That's what I was like. You know, I'm curious to see how long her hair would get. I wouldn't leave it long, but I would. I think it's most.
Good job.
It seems like it grows every day.
She's just like, I like when people give me treats.
Would you like one?
No.
They have ponytails usually on the top of their heads.
She's a sweetheart.
She looks fabulous.
She can be a little pushy when she meets other dogs.
Yeah.
So she'd be a great only dog. She loves people and kids, like she loves adults and kids. And I think with the right personality for other, like another dog that's really tolerant because she's kind of obnoxious. She does great in playgroup at PACC, but she can't be housed with other dogs because she doesn't get along well with them when they're in a confined environment. So. Well, actually, she does play well. She doesn't live well.
That's well,
yeah. Right. Right. Right.
You gotta really stretch
to be able to pet her because
she's so far down. I'm used to the
rest of the movie. Yeah, like, I know. Here, you know, the bird, like,
she is a good size. Yeah. Yeah.
She's
not gonna be any bigger than that, right? No, that's it. She's all done. Well, she's 4 years old. About 4, yeah. Oh, yeah. And it's a guess. She came in as a stray, so the shelter doesn't really know. But generally, they take a look like their teeth and everything. Yeah. Her energy level and stuff, I think for her it's probably accurate. Some of the other things, yeah.
But the what?
No, that she's about 4.
Oh.
3 or 4 years old. Because she's not super, like, she's not really hyper or super playful. She'll get playful, but it's like short stretches. She's not like Esper who would bounce off, literally bounce off the walls here.
Do you cry when you were playing with Camilla?
Good way and that girl gets so excited.
Thanks for visiting.
Like when she gets a treat, she and then she just thinks, "Now let's go." And you know what? They're kind of all taking naps. It's that time of day.
I'm ready.
Yes. Yes.
It really is.
It's okay, you can always come in.
Thanks for coming in, everybody.
So,
two of the drivers were here early.
Uh-huh.
And I looked at them and I said, it's a quarter hour. Do you guys want to start taking off? They're like, now? I'm like,
yeah.
I said, because there's only one person to unload this afternoon over there. I said, so if you guys go and we each have one dog, by the time and Wayne get back with the other three, because I was going to run home at 10, that it'll be, you know, by the time they actually got the dogs down there and got them away, it was almost 2 o'clock anyway, but it, they went back and
yes.
were more sporadic than usual. But they were just funny, they're like, you're really done. I'm like, I'm finished with this.
Oh, I'm fried. Yes. Totally fried.
Well, look at the, because
look at
Thursday.
Look at
what are you doing, handsome boy?
You are adorable, bud.
Look at that.
Oh my God.
He's so grown. He's
so cute.
So, guess who started in your belly?
Oh, really?
Well, I know. Been a minute. She does this. Okay, Connor was, this will be the third Christmas coming because I got him in December. Okay. So we've been through two Christmases. Okay. All right. And then Camila, I got right before I went to see my mom last year. Yeah. And so she's had this like she never did it. And then she has this half baked like rollover. Like she'll keep her legs like this and she'll go like this. And it's like, okay, you're lame. And then finally, and then I'd go down and rub the bottom part. And then, like, Comet, he throws his cup. I mean, he is the tummy rub guy, okay? And so I came in the door, and they just creep. And then he's on, he rolled over. I couldn't believe it.
You know, it's funny, because when I came out with her that time and saw him,
He's
huge. He's just the tiniest little.
He's
know. Like here. I remember that day. That first day.
Yeah, he was in
that.
You couldn't even tell.
No. So when I saw him, I was like, "Holy crap!"
Man.
He's like, I brought him. I brought her out to do meetings.
Yeah,
right?
You did. You brought him to the condo.
Yeah.
I mean, he's.
So yeah, I'm like, you do that with everyone? Hell no. I do that for everyone. I'm not even sure you follow
No.
Oh, anybody on the Sunday crew?
Yeah.
Most of the other days, I don't know.
But I am so glad that when I called you, that, you know, you talked me down off the roof. And then I was able to figure out, like, end the call.
Yeah.
And
well,
then
and like
when you gave
there's
me
a,
the
there's
A-OK.
There's a proper
like,
use for it.
Yes.
It's a wonderfully useful tool when it's used appropriately.
Yes.
The problem is it shouldn't be sold in just any
right.
store.
Right.
Because 90% of the people that use it, and they think they're supposed to take the rubber covers off the pinchers. No, you're not supposed to do that. That's not
good.
That shouldn't be, that's, oh my God, I can't tell you how many dogs over the years I've seen come in the pack with like a necklace of puncture holes all the way around the neck.
And
some idiot can use prong call along because they
And you know,
so
I got the minis. You know, there's the big size prongs,
right.
And then I got the minis.
Right.
And they work just fine. Okay.
Well, the whole point behind it is supposed to pinch. That's what the first supposed to pinch.
Exactly.
It's a sensation. It's like using
right.
a bark collar on the lowest setting.
Right.
I think that's acceptable as well. There's different tools.
I used one on my chihuahua.
There's some dogs that respond. Some dogs respond wonderfully to sunshine.
Yeah. Like,
Max, please don't do that ever again. And the dog will never do it again.
Yeah.
95% of dogs I've ever encountered at PACC are the kind of dogs that like have to know who's in charge.
Yeah.
And that's probably why I can do what I can do with most of
yeah.
the dogs. But there's a few, like, Monkey needs somebody to take charge, but not in a, like,
stern
military fashion. Because he'll balk at that. Like, I can see it. He was right there with that guy last week. He listened to him, but I could see he was also like,
does this
come towards
this
me
year?
Anymore? Yeah.
Oh.
Like, come at me a little bit more, and I'm going to get back up in your face. So, like, with him, you kind of have to find right where
yeah.
his sweet spot
he's going to listen.
And that look on his face, I mean, it's intimidating.
It is, because he stares right through you.
Look, and you kind of like, you'll look at you, and you're like.
That was what Brennan was like. And it's weird that he and Brennan look so much alike, too, but Brennan was the same way. Brennan would look at me, and I'm like, are you about to wag and lick me, or are you going to take my face off?
Exactly.
I couldn't tell the difference.
Right.
So,
yeah, that's
I've been keeping tabs. Ginger hasn't come back. So,
oh my God,
I can't believe that.
I can't believe
I'm
it.
I'm worried that maybe she got loose because, you know, she did it before. But,
wow.
I'm hoping she may have gone
was
the right
she an
person.
Only dog?
I have no idea
oh.
about anything about her dog.
Oh, because she was down there and got
yeah.
Wow, that's. Well, it was you know.
No, we tried.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, she got a lot more than she would have gotten.
She was great, but.
What that thing was at the very end where she decided she would, what was that?
What, well, here.
It's all trauma surfacing.
I think something happened. I think it was during those couple of weeks that they were in the doctor, something happened with somebody. And as I said that to Kelly, I said, I don't know if it was staff, volunteer, or if it was a member of the public, but some, because she did it, we saw it that day. She did it twice that day. That was the last day she got that.
Yeah. Thank God Brian said, because all he did was reach forward and grab her by the back of the harness. And as the guy walked down, she did, she tried to go right over, and that's what she did to me the day before. Same thing, she tried to go right over the top of that ass.
No bikini for the child either, huh?
No, it's a toy chihuahua. It's a little small for all that.
He was too cute this morning when time rolled up. I didn't see him. He was between the two of them. And then he looked up and he saw me, and I looked at him, and I saw the whole body start to wiggle. She said, as soon as he saw you, he don't have anything to do with us anymore. And Anna had said that to me last 2 weeks ago about Ari. Because she dropped him off in the morning on Sunday, and she said, he was all content to sit right there next to me, and he was he was waggy, and then he saw me through the front window, and that was it.
It was like that recognition. You know, and
well, and that's what it is. Like yesterday, I was having a problem because he was over here yesterday. So he and Weaver. If I was in with one, the other one was not happy. I'm like, I am not your mother. You are not mine.
They triggered each other.
Well, these two.
Notice how different they both are today. Neither one of them are barking today.
But they're kind of sort of like that. You could see, like, he was getting treats and he wanted them, you know?
Yeah.
And then was whining because he was getting attention, all these over here getting attention. And he was, like, really sad about it.
He's a character, that dog. He's
is.
A sweet guy.
He is.
I was really hoping that we were going to find somebody this week so he could either go to foster or adopt it because I don't. He came in with another dog that they think might be his mother. She's smaller. She's like a healer mix. And she bit somebody right after they got back. She got a central pack at a central pet staff person. So she's been on quarantine. I was really hoping we'd be able to get him out because I know what's going to happen. And the well-intentioned volunteers there are going to try to keep him together. Because they're mother and son. And they've been together his whole life. And all the things that they put out there. But in a situation like that, he's going to end up sitting for weeks and weeks, if not months.
While his mother is...
Right, because she's got a bite. She's got a bite history. And she doesn't do well in stressful situations.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you know... As a general rule, I don't think that parents or siblings, parents and offspring or siblings should get together. But that being said, what were their names? Buttercup and Binksy? So the two, they were gone, they left the Saturday before you guys came in the next day. They were the ones that told the story that So they posted an update, and if I knew where I could find it, I'd show it to you because the two look so happy. They're in foster home, and they're all smart. They're not shaved because they're just matted. Their fur is a hot mess, so they took them over and they shaved them down. And they're just like, their faces are just, you know, they're happy. So it's really good to see.
Yeah. Sometimes it's really not appropriate to separate them.
No, and that. And Buttercup stayed by her mom. And the ABS officers came
to them. I remember that
dog. So when they came for them, when they went down into the wash, into the bridge that they were living under, when they went down to get them, she was a basket case while they were, because they had to get like a stretcher to lift the mom, she couldn't walk. So.
She was probably so protective.
She was super protective.
Like that, she was a caretaker.
Yep.
And so that's why.
That's why I said, you know, she, I think she would be lost. Mom would have been okay without her.
Exactly.
She needed mom. You know,
yes,
that was her job. That was her life. And the thing is that if it happens after this, that's one thing. But to separate them during such a traumatic time in their lives would have just been, it would have been a mistake. And I'm not normally a huge advocate of keeping dogs together. I usually feel the opposite. Don't tug at my heartstrings.
Yes,
because I'm going to work on you. But those two, after them being here for the couple days that we had them up here, I felt very strongly they needed to stay together. And I was so, so glad that we were able to get them